Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from 11 Maret University, Indonesia. My name is Bayu Aji Prasetya.
And my name is Nelima Novitasari.
Today, we will present our research about Kitab Pengajaran Manuskrip. Kitab Pengajaran is one of the manuscripts stored in British Library with the manuscript number MSS Malay B13. This manuscript contains moral teaching in daily life, which are divided into 9 parts and 31 clauses. The teaching in the Kitab Pengajaran Manuscript is conveyed in simple language and expression that are relevant to the Al-Quran and Hadith. In addition to teaching, the text also states what this us should be avoided or become prohibited by Allah. This study or this research is a qualitative descriptive with the object Kitab Pengajaran Manuscript Collection of the British Library, England. In this research, the data collection technique began with inventory of the manuscript, then continued with observation of the metadata on the British Library website, then discussion. The title of the manuscript is Kitab Pengajaran. This is known from the first page of the manuscript, which can be read bahwa ini kitab pengajaran pada segala orang. The translate that this is kitab pengajaran to all people. The title of the manuscript can be seen in the first page. The manuscript has 20 cm length and 12 cm width with total of 208 pages. And each page consists of 13 lines. The type of khat is nashi. Paying debt and keep the promises. In the first clause of the 6th chapter of the Kitab Pengajaran Manuscript, explain that if you have debts, you must be pay it. Often small problems such as the expression of brotherhood and friendship rise because of debt problems. This is explained in the 120th page of the Kitab Pengajaran Manuskrip. Artian, maka hendaklah kamu barang hutangmu dengan sebetulnya, karena orang itu yang sudah meminjam padamu telah sudah percaya barang perlakuanmu. This is relevant with the Al-Quran Surah Al-Baqarah verse 282. On August 19th, 2020, a man in Sukoharjo, Central Java, killed 4 people who were one family member. The motive is because he was in debt, so he want to rob their car. However, it can be prevented if you have good financial planning. Good financial planning can be realized with zero budgeting method for the fixed and variable expenses. Honest and keep the oral. The next moral teaching in the Kitab Pengajaran Manuscript are honesty and keep the oral. It is explained that why someone says or speak come from their heart, so it can be seen by they speak. Kitab Pengajaran Manuscript explain, maka bahasa orang yang benar itu pun terbit daripada pakar hatinya, dan perkataannya tiada culas dan pura-pura adanya. Maka ia menjadi malu perkataannya yang bohong. This is relevant with Al-Quran Surah Al-Ma'idah verse 8. Allah emphasized that someone should be honest without being based on certain elements or to anyone, including to the enemy.
The first clause on the 6th chapter explained that the activity of trading should not seek too much profit because it could be causing riba or usury. The usury is forbidden because it would take other people's wealth and could make someone to be a greedy person. This activity has forbid and mentioned on Quran Surah Al-Baqarah verse 275. Allah has permitted trading and forbidden riba or usury. So there are some rules how to take a profit from trading, although there are some different opinion about the amount of profit that could be taken. Some ulama argue that profit taking could be adjusted to the current market price. Some other ulama argue the profit taking should not be more than 1/3 of the capital price. Other ulama argue the profit taking should not be more than 1/6 of the capital price. There are two kinds of riba. First, riba nasi'ah, or sometimes mentioned as riba duyun. Riba nasi'ah is riba that arise due to the receivable debt activity that are not in accordance with the Sharia. Riba nasi'ah requires the payment of debt made by the debtor with a nominal greater than nominal of the loan and will be fined if the payment exceeds the deadline. Not only the perpetrator of the debt who incurs it, but the representative, the minutes, and the two witnesses also incur sin when in the activities of debt there is a riba or usury. Second, riba fadl is riba that arises due to the exchange of similar goods that are not of the same quality. For example, sell gold for gold, silver for silver, debt for debt, flour for flour, but if the measure is the value of the property, then the profit is not included as riba fadl. It's not included a riba. Gratitude chapter. According the psychological research by Sonia and Seldon, gratitude could reduce negative character in a person because the person always has a feeling that everything they receive in their life is a grace from Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. The teaching of gratitude is mentioned in Kitab Pengajaran in 4th clause in 6th chapter. Kitab Pengajaran taught that the behavior of gratitude is more allowed by Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala because gratitude could keep people from envy and jealousy. It also mentioned in Surah An-Nisa, verse 32. Do not covet what God has given to someone of you more than other men have the portion they have earned, and women the portion they have earned. You should rather ask for some of His bounty. He has full knowledge of everything. God has said to stay away from the envy and jealousy because God has arranged everything in this world. Everyone has their own strength and weakness, and those would be a symbiosis that provided benefit for each other. Gratitude could also be done in several ways, such as always feeling enough with the graces that have been received, giving alms to those who need, and feel happy when the other gets sustenance or grace. However, in Kitab Pengajaran also explained that he is not allowed to mention what has been given to others. It mentioned in Quran Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 264. Because mentioning what has been given could hurt the people who receive the alms. Kitab Pengajaran also taught someone should not receive anything from people that can be trusted or the thing from something that haram. But if we don't know that the thing is haram or not, it allowed to receive the things. Because if we knew the thing is haram and we still receive, it still counts as a sin. The conclusion of the research is, based on the explanation of the sixth part of the Kitab Pengajaran manuscript, the thing written come from the teachings that are relevant to the Al-Quran and Hadith. This is evidenced by the correlation between the teachings contained in the manuscripts and the teachings contained in the Al-Quran, even though Kitab Pengajaran manuscript is conveyed in a different language style. Kitab Pengajaran manuscript teach ethics and moral values that must be applied in daily life. A lot of things that occur in society are caused due to a moral crisis. Therefore, moral education needs to be taught and applied from an early age, so that it could become an intelligent society and be followed by good moral skills.
Thank you for the attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.